Luke and Brian, talk to us about some of the cover crops that we've seen this morning in the field and share with us this new philosophy about trap crops and sugar beet.
One thing we were really mindful about when we started this, and our first little bit was working with the University of Idaho, was, okay, what species are we bringing into Idaho? What are we bringing here? You know, is anything going to become a weed for us? Just to make sure we're doing our due diligence of what we plant. And so that's where we kind of got real mindful about what is each individual item going to provide for us or help us with. We started to look at individual items that were built for nematode control, specifically in our case, sugar beet cyst nematode control. And that was really a couple key reasons. One, we're located fairly close to the Paul sugar factory, so there's been sugar beets here for 100 years. And so when we have so much crop rotation of a single crop, you know, we started to develop that pest pretty significantly. So we started by looking at that with, you know, a few sources, University of Idaho, and then some, you know, partners in industry to find out what could we use as a biological control for this nematode. And that kind of led us down the path of looking at some of these radishes, some of these mustards. There's a few around. Some you'll see some of the trade names, you know, like Control or Concord or Defender. And a lot of it came out of German research after the 80s when they started to lose the ability to use some fumigants, that they started to look at these biological controls. So for our program, because our core rotation for the farm is sugar beets and potatoes, we always go through and are trying to find items that are either nematode targeting that'll reduce the nematode population or at least neutral. So we're not hosting, you know, the same pests or diseases that, you know, would affect our cash crops. And so a lot of the times, and then, you know, with a lot of help and kind of pushing from NRCS to say, okay, we've got a few of those, how can we build diversity? We started to real aggressively go look and try to find neutral cover crops that we could add into those. So a lot of times now in my place, we'll use a lot of nematode control oilseed radish instead of the daikon style radish. We feel like we get the same tillage effect or even more with more lateral roots, but we're not hosting problem for our sugar beets. And then a white mustard. And then we've been able to identify some things like bursine clover, flax, phacelia, that we can put in there that are neutral, so we're not going to build, you know, a bigger population of that harmful nematode. No. So we can hit our diversity goals for ourselves to create a little more biodiversity. What I love about it, it's nothing that we produce commercially, so it's a real disease break. Because we're shifting totally, you know, from small grain or you know beets and potatoes to these cover crops that we don't commercially produce in our area, we get a nice disease break plus pest control.